After receiving a cancer diagnosis, many people turn to the internet to learn more about their cancer. The internet can be a good source of health information, but there is a lot of misinformation online as well.
Medical misinformation is information that is false, inaccurate, or misleading. Misinformation can be harmful to patients. If they are seeing information online that is not accurate, that may impact their choice to take a medication or not. That may impact their plan for their cancer treatment and ultimately can result in negative outcomes.
Trying to identify which information online is reliable can be overwhelming. You should always look closely at the source of the information. If it hasn't been vetted by a medical professional, it may not be trustworthy.
It can be really hard to identify cancer misinformation online. There is so much out there, and weeding through it, figuring out what's accurate, what's not accurate, what applies to you, what doesn't apply to you, is challenging. The first step is going to resources that are providing evidence-based, accurate information. For example, Cancer.Net is a great patient-centered website that shares accurate information. The second step is looking at someone's credentials on social media. Are they a physician? Are they a nurse? Are they a nurse practitioner? Are they a cancer dietitian? Are they a social worker? And the list goes on, but understanding where you're getting that information from and who is providing that information can be really helpful. It is really important for patients to be aware of certain red flags that they can look for to help them figure out whether information is credible or not. One of the red flags is going to be a term that says cancer can be cured with this treatment, or if you do this, your cancer will go away completely. A second red flag is going to be information that is not presented with credentials. What I mean by that is if a person on social media defines themselves as a cancer expert but does not back that up with credentials, that is always a red flag to watch out for. The way to identify credible and reliable information, again, is to know who is providing it and to really take a look at how that information is being presented. What I mean by that is if you see a fact or a claim on social media, is it linked to a study? Is it linked to research? Can you follow the source back? I think it's also important to look at if that information is provided by a company, you know, what the funding source is, because, you know, a lot of times there is gain to be had from some information that we see online.
There are many online forums where patients post about their own cancer journeys, and those can provide a source of comfort and community for people with cancer. However, it's important to remember that their experiences may not be the same as yours.
We know that patients are online telling their stories, sharing their experiences, their journeys, and that is really important. I think that seeing what someone else went through, what side effects they had, how they handled their treatment is such powerful information. But I caution patients to understand that one person's experience may not be what happens to you. And I think it's important to gather all that data to understand what other patients are experiencing so that you know what may happen, but understanding that that does not always apply to your experience.
It is important not to make any medical decisions based solely on what you read online. Your cancer care team can help you sort through the information and answer any questions you have about what you see online.
I always urge patients to take whatever information they find online and talk to their healthcare team about it. And that probably is one of the best ways to weed out that information.